My name is Nami Saito.
Hi, my name is Elena Nielsen.
Hi, my name is Naomi Sanukawa.
Hi, my name is Stephanie G.
Hi, my name is Yuki Nishimura.
Welcome to the 52nd Annual Northern California Cherry Blossom Festival Feeding Program.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 52nd Annual Cherry Blossom Festival's Queen Program. My name is Jana Katsuyama. I am a reporter for the 10 o'clock news and 11 p.m. news on KTVU, Fox 2 News. And this is my 10th year emceeing this event, one of my favorites of the entire year, partly as you will see from these young ladies tonight, just the tremendous amount of spirit and community growth that we're going to be seeing from these young women. I'd like to introduce my co-MC tonight, Devin Katsuyama from KQED News.
Thank you so much. Yeah, I host a podcast for KQED. It's called The Bay. And believe it or not, this is my first time emceeing this event, and I'm super excited to be here. And thank you all for coming out and supporting. So give yourselves a round of applause.
And I'm so excited because when I first heard Devin, people would come up to me and say, "Are you guys related?" And I'm like, "It's Katsuyama and Katsuyama." Uh-huh. So, but this is our first time working together, but it's going to be such a fun evening. So thank you all for joining us today. The opening number with the 2019 candidates was choreographed by the 2017 Cherry Blossom Queen and Nishikawa Ryu Natori dancer Jacqueline Kimiko Chu. So please give the candidates and also the former queen a round of applause for their work on the opening number. That was lovely. This Queen program really encourages and advocates for young Japanese American women to step up and take a vital role in our communities at large. It's a mentorship program that helps these young women develop into confident, successful, and outstanding citizens. And it gives them an opportunity to reach out into various organizations within the Northern California community, as well as in Japan, and try to make a difference.
Throughout this next year, these candidates are going to have the opportunity to network with prominent Japanese Americans, politicians, and diplomats, not only here in Northern California, but throughout other Japanese American communities and in Japan.
And we'd like to, at this point, please welcome the co-chairpersons of the 52nd Annual Northern California Cherry Blossom Festival, Ms. Kelly Yuka Walton and Ms. Alicia Asaki Osato.
Thank you. On behalf of the Queen Program Committee, welcome to the 52nd Annual Northern California Cherry Blossom Festival Queen Program Night. こんばんは。 My name is Asaki Osato, and this is my dear friend, Yuka Walton. The last time the two of us stood together on this stage was exactly 6 years ago, when I was crowning her as the 2013 queen. If you would have told us then that we would be back on this stage as co-chairs of this program, we wouldn't have believed you. But we've experienced firsthand the impact that this program has on the future leaders of the Japanese American community. As candidates, we spent months learning about the history of our community, experienced many Japanese cultural arts, and practiced our leadership skills, like public speaking. And as a court, we put these leadership skills to use as we volunteered at a multitude of community events. As homegrown leaders, we are honored to take on this new responsibility as co-chairs. Watching our dynamic and diverse group of committee members come together this past year has been incredibly inspiring. And being mentored by Mr. Ben Nakajo, our chairperson emeritus, a founding member of many organizations in our community, and definitely one of the most hardworking, selfless, and committed volunteer we've ever met, has brought us deeper appreciation to this program. As a nonprofit organization, this program has relied solely on the generosity of sponsors, donors, and members of our community. And it is because of each and every one of you here tonight that we are able to celebrate our 52nd anniversary this year. From the bottom of our hearts, thank you for your continued support.
Every year, this night fills my heart with so much joy because I'm humbled by the deeper meaning of our gathering. Here we are, 300 people gathered together in one space to celebrate and empower female leaders. The power of investing in female leadership is something our community has known for a long time. In 1921, when discriminated against and not allowed to join the YWCA, the Issei women started their very own JYWCA that focused on leadership and skills training. Then in the 1930s, they were able to build their own building just two blocks from here on Sutter Street through funds raised by the local community, which was quite an incredible feat considering that many were financially struggling from the Great Depression. But from the very beginning, our community has known that investing in female leadership is extremely important. Our own program, now in its 52nd year, has over 250 alumni who are leaders in education, medicine, business, law, and government. Our alumni serve on the boards of various Japanese American nonprofits throughout Northern California. I am passionate and deeply committed to the work of the Queen Program because I truly believe that it is one of the most important leadership pipelines for the next generation of community leaders. In a time where we know that females are underpaid and underrepresented in the highest levels of government and corporations, I'm so thankful to our Japanese American community for its continued emphasis and support on female leadership. Aside from being a celebration of female leadership, I love this night because it feels like one big family reunion. And for those of you who know me, I love hugs and I love seeing all of you. I love it. It feels like people coming back together to reconnect and to express love and gratitude to each other and the community. So whether this is your first time at Program Night or your 52nd time at Program Night, We are so thankful that you're here to be a part of our big and loving Queen Program family. As we look forward to the future of the Queen Program, the Cherry Blossom Festival, and the larger Japanese American community, we know our future is bright because our continued connections make our community stronger. Thank you.
Thank you both, ladies.
So tonight the candidates will be scored in four categories, which we're going to be going through as we go through the program. Earlier, our panel of judges had a chance to interview each candidate individually in the personal interview segment.
The personal interview segment is weighted with 35% of the overall score. They're judged upon their articulation, their presentation, personal philosophy, their professionalism, and also their honesty and their candor. It is now time to get a chance to get to know the candidates a little bit better.
The candidates have prepared a speech for tonight based on the prompted question, as part of this court and a future community leader, how do I hope to contribute to the Northern California Japanese American community? Now, this speech is going to be 20% of their overall score, and it's going to be judged on their ability to clearly answer the question, their poise, their personality, intellect, maturity, creativity, and overall presentation.
We'd like to now, once again, invite to the stage, in their beautiful Fujiyasu Furisode kimonos, the 52nd annual Northern California Cherry Blossom Festival Queen candidates.
Sponsor Benihana for their generosity, and to my family and friends for their encouragement and support as I embark on my journey with the Queen Program. Currently, I am a senior at Sacred Heart Cathedral Preparatory, planning to pursue a field in clinical psychology to help disabled kids in the future. As a member of this court and future community leader, I hope to become a role model for the children of the next generation. I hope to embody a person who is proud of who they are, their culture, their heritage, and their racial identity. When I was younger, I was embarrassed of having a Japanese name, which often got pronounced wrong, and I disliked the fact that I had to go to Japanese school every Saturday while my friends were spending time together. And I only felt comfortable speaking in Japanese and embracing my Japanese culture in front of my fellow Japanese peers. But as I grew up, I realized the luxury I had been given to be bilingual and to be able to experience both cultures. I realized what it truly means to be a Japanese American and what it looks like to be proud of the traditions within my culture. Moving forward, I would like to spread the peace within the Japanese American community to all others around the world. I would like to thank all of you here tonight for your support, and again to my sponsor, Benihana. Please
enjoy the rest of your evening. Thank you. And Nami says she coordinates her closet by color and has an obsession with Olaf, the snowman in the Disney film Frozen.
Also, if she could eat one thing the rest of her life, it's gotta be meatloaf.
All right. On to candidate number two.
Nielsen. I majored in sociology at UC Berkeley, and I'm currently pursuing a career in Japanese American nonprofit work. Thank you all so much for being here tonight. I'd especially like to thank my sponsor, Nikkei Lions Club, whose continued commitment to the Japanese American community has enabled me to be on this stage tonight. I've always been really shy, but I can stand here tonight because our community helped me grow. To me, that is the core of what it means to be Japanese American. Through programs and personal ties, we cultivate each other to reach our fullest potential, like an extended family. This is our culture. When I moved to Tokyo 3 years ago, I missed our community, so I created the group Nikkei in Japan. As a yonsei, the group was based off of Japanese American organizations. However, it would have been impossible to run without Japanese speaking members. These members were Kikoku Shijo, an identity I'd never even heard of. However, we connected on issues of mixed identity, and together, we created something new. We became a Nikkei family, the first group of our kind in Japan. Some people worry about the future of our community, but we have so much potential. We are multi-generational. We are mixed race. We are queer. We are Japan-born and more. By embracing our natural diversity, we can only expand. As a member of this court, I want to help all members of our family feel proud and supported for who they are. Because together, there's no limit to how we can grow. Thank you all so much for listening. And again, thank you to Nikkei Lions Club for giving me this platform.
Whenever Elena reads or hears something really moving or funny, she writes it down in a little notebook that she calls her quote book.
Right. And she also has walked the entire Tokyo Yamamote train line, all 29 stations within one day.
And she's also climbed Mount Fuji.
On to candidate number 3. Good
evening, everyone. Thank you so much for attending this evening as we begin this journey with the Queen Program. I would like to take a moment to thank my sponsor, Takarasake USA Incorporated, for allowing me to be before you this evening and for their continued support and generosity for our community. My name is Naomi Furukawa. I graduated from San Francisco State University with a degree in international relations. I'm currently working at Handshake in San Francisco and at Takarasake USA Incorporated. Growing up, it was difficult for me to feel like I belonged. As a 4.5 generation Japanese American, the community organizations that I participated in were fundamental not only to my understanding of my heritage, but also to the formation of my identity. Yet, as I grew older, I began to understand that there's significant separation between our community groups. The stories of the Issei and the Nisei are not relatable for my peers. And many of the Shin Issei and Shin Nisei entering into our community don't understand the history of Japanese in America. I want to help merge the narratives, the stories and legacies of those Issei and Nisei pioneers with young Japanese Americans trying to find their voices in modern America. I know that my participation in community groups was so fundamental to knowing who I am, and I believe that by helping other young individuals to participate in community organizations and community activities, I can help other young people, young Japanese Americans, understand who they are and find their identities. Only by understanding our heritage and where we come from can we truly know not only who we are today, but where we're going tomorrow. Once again, thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen, for coming this evening and joining us as we begin this journey.
Naomi says that she knows a lot of trivia and enjoys telling her friends random facts.
She also has a very eclectic taste in music and enjoys listening to classical, pop, rock, and country. And Naomi also loves baking and cooking.
On to candidate number four.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for being here today to support the beginning of our journey. I would especially like to thank my sponsor, Nihonmachi Street Fair, for their continuous generosity to the Cherry Blossom Festival and Queen Program. My name is Stephanie Leiko Chi. I'm 26 years old and I graduated from San Francisco State University with a Bachelor's of Science in Microbiology. I currently work as a clinical laboratory scientist at UCSF, one of the leading hospitals in the country. 18 years ago, I started dancing with the Michiya Hanayagi dance group. I was captivated by the beautiful storytelling through intricately placed movements. Performing all over the Bay Area has allowed me to connect with people, my culture, and most importantly, myself, in a new and enlightening way. Odori has given me a voice that speaks louder than words and a message worth sharing. Now, when I take the stage, I hope to get the audience to look beyond what's on the surface, an art that not only wants to be seen, but practiced. I feel so proud knowing that the movements you see today are the same movements from the generations that came before us. As part of the Cherry Blossom Festival Court, I want to explore new ways to reveal the value of tradition to the Japanese American youth early in life and set the example that there's no age limit to practice tradition. By sharing my love for Japanese dance, I hope to inspire members of our community to not only love their culture, but embrace it. I want to help others find their own voice and work together to keep our traditions alive. Once again, I would like to thank my sponsor, Nihonmachi Street Fair, for allowing me this once in a lifetime opportunity. Thank you. Yes!
Folds paper cranes to relieve stress and has folded more than 10,000 cranes in her lifetime.
That's a lot. She also recently became interested in traveling and says that she wants to visit 30 states before she turns 30. Next, we're moving on to candidate number five.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Yuki Nishimura, and I am 26 years old. I graduated from the University of Toronto with a major in neuroscience and a double minor in bioethics and English literature. I currently work as a lab research assistant, and I'm hoping to further my studies in the near future. I'd like to take a moment to thank each and every one of you for making it out here tonight. I'd love to especially thank my sponsor, the Japanese Chamber of Commerce of Northern California, for their continued support of this program and for providing me with this treasured opportunity. If I'm reborn again, I don't want to be Asian. I felt the pain and guilt in your voice as you cried these words to me, and it was all too familiar. I remember in those tender years when I too wanted nothing more than to fit in and to erase my otherness. When something as simple as unribboning my bento box meant a certain daily, embarrassing ritual for me. The few places of comfort were the Saturday Japanese school and the Japanese supermarkets, as well as the yearly cherry blossom festival, where I got to see a celebration of my roots. But still, I struggled as you do now, and as so many others like you do. For me, it wasn't until I joined my Japanese martial arts group, the Northern California Naginata Federation, that I began to see the strength and beauty that our culture holds, and to want to commemorate our differences that make us both American and Japanese. As part of this court, I want to share this with you and to show you that you're not alone. I want to be a beacon to guide you through your own self-celebration, so that one day you'll stand as ever beautiful as you are now and say, I'm so proud to be Japanese American. Once again, I'd love to thank my sponsor, the Japanese Chamber of Commerce, Northern California, and everyone else here tonight. I truly hope that you enjoy the rest of our program here. Thank you.
Yuki is excited about representing Team USA this summer at the World Naginata Friendship Tournament in Germany, and she has also summited Mount Fuji twice.
Yuki likes to watch movies and TV shows such as Game of Thrones and Newsroom. She also likes to read, and sometimes she'll write down interesting phrases in those books about those books and movies. Please give our five accomplished young women a round of applause.
I know that isn't easy to get up first thing and give speeches in front of a whole audience. Well done. We would now like to extend a very warm welcome to the Deputy Consul General of Japan in San Francisco, the Honorable Kazuhiro Iru. He will come and give a few words.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and konbanwa. It's a great honor to join you for the 2019 Northern California Cherry Blossom Queen Program. My name is, again, Kazuhiro Iru, the Deputy Consul General of the Consul General of Japan in San Francisco. At the Consulate, we are truly appreciative for the Queen Program, which provides a valuable opportunity for young Japanese-American women to form deeper connections with their heritage and community. These current and future leaders will also serve as representative of the Cherry Blossom Festival and the Japanese American Committee of Northern California, locally and at the national and even international levels. I congratulate the Queen Program Committee and especially co-chairs Ms. Kerry Walton and Ms. Asaki Osato, Chairperson Emeritus Mr. Ben Nakajo, and Program Director Ms. Jacqueline Chu. It is comforting to know that this grand tradition continues in the hands of its next generation leadership. This program is but one of many ways that Northern California Cherry Blossom connects our people through a network of friendship. Tonight, we have a special opportunity to recognize the numerous and varied achievements of five capable young women. I know that each of you will continue to represent yourselves and your community as members of this year's cohort and as distinguished role models throughout your lives and careers. I thank each of you for investing this year to learn more about Japan and its culture. And in turn, I'm certain you will each perform admirably as ambassadors, connecting Japan and Northern California in a number of ways. I wish the candidates the best night and throughout the year on the court. We will certainly hear many great things from these women as they rise to meet their bright futures. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Deputy Consul General, representing the Consulate of Japan. Our candidates would now like to take a moment to thank their individual sponsors with the assistance of our 2018 Cherry Blossom Queen and Court.
Nami Katie Saito is sponsored by Benihana.
And tonight, receiving on behalf of Benihana's general manager, Mr. Jeffrey Perry, Ben Nakajo is representing, accompanied by 2018 Court Princess Rachel Mika Kawawaki. Many thanks to Benihana.
The Nikkei Lions Club of San Francisco is the sponsor of Elena and Harumi Nielsen.
And tonight, coming onto the stage, the president of the Nikkei Lions Club, Mr. Bruce Iwafuchi, is accompanied by 2018 Princess Lauren Kieva Matsuno. Many thanks to the Nikkei Lions Club.
Next, we have Naomi Leilani Furukawa, sponsored by Takara Sake USA Incorporated.
And tonight, coming onto the stage, accompanied by the 2018 Princess Emily Sakurai, please welcome Mr. Shigeki Azuma, Senior Manager of Sales and Marketing. Thank you so much to Takara Sake.
Stephanie Reiko Gee is sponsored by the Neonmachi Street Fair.
And coming onto the stage, representing the Neonmachi Street Fair is Chairperson Mr. Richard Ju, who is accompanied by the 2018 Queen, Nicole May Jen Tachiki. Many thanks to the Nihonmachi Street Fair.
And last but not least, we have Yuki Nishimura, sponsored by the Japanese Chamber of Commerce of Northern California.
And tonight, gracing our stage, please welcome the newly elected president, Mr. Tomomichi Saito. Mr. Saito is accompanied by the 2018 First Princess, Maya Hernandez. Thank you so much to the Japanese Chamber of Commerce of Northern California.
The Queen Program would like to convey their deepest gratitude for the continuous support of the candidate sponsors.
Thank you all so much. Thank you to the sponsors for being here tonight. We would now like to move to a very important part of this Queen Program tradition. If you look across the stage, you'll notice the beautiful kimono that is displayed. It is a kimono donated by the Fujiyasu Kimono Company as a gift to whomever will receive the queen title tonight.
For the history of this festival's relationship with the Fujiyasu Kimono Company, please welcome former queen, Ms. Jacqueline Kimiko Chu.
Since 1973, the Fujiyasu Kimono Company has donated one of their gorgeous furisode kimonos as a prize for each year's newly selected Northern California Cherry Blossom Festival Queen. More than a gift, these furisodes have been a symbol of the company's goodwill and of the bond between Japan and the Japanese American community. After World War II, Japan was left in a devastated state, with many struggling to survive without basic food, shelter, and supplies. At the same time, here in America, Japanese Americans struggle to rebuild their lives after being sent to internment camps. While both sides grappled in the aftermath of war, the connection between them remained as powerful as ever. Despite losing most of their personal properties except what they had been able to carry with them, Japanese Americans recognized that those back in Japan were in even greater need. The Japanese American community rallied around this cause, came together, and sent provisions they barely had themselves back to Japan, with the Northern California Japanese American community alone sending more than 3 tons of supplies. These Japanese Americans showed Japanese that there was grace and beauty even after this dark time in history, and that the connections between them would never falter. Each year since 1973, the Queen's Fujiyasu Furisode has been a symbol of that bond, that resilience, that generosity, that gratitude. Because one of those recipients of those post-war supplies was the late Mr. Seishichi Ato, former president of the Fujiyasu Kimono Company, who vowed to give back to those who had so selflessly given to him. This year's furisode represents the 47th anniversary of this tradition, with this year's queen the 47th beneficiary of this legacy. Though these furisode began as a symbol of appreciation, what they have provided to these young Japanese American women and to this community is truly priceless. In a time when many Japanese American women have never even worn a kimono, the opportunity to wear one of these exquisite furisodes is magical. From the flourish of florals, detailed embroidery, to the dazzling colors, wearing one of these furisodes is a cultural experience unlike any other. Through their generous donations, the Fujiyasu Kimono Company has given dozens of women the chance to stand before thousands and wear their heritage with pride. Tonight, while we celebrate 5 young women and their passion for the Japanese American community, we also celebrate the history that has shaped our community into what it is today. The Fujiyasu Kimono Company and its furisodes represent a legacy of goodwill we could never repay and can only ever start to recompense through gratitude for the sacrifices of those before us and by remembering the strength of the bonds between us. It's with this in mind that we express our deepest appreciation to the Fujiyasu Kimono Company and are honored to continue this tradition of goodwill and gratitude tonight. Thank you. Thank you, Jackie.
So as we mentioned earlier, the judges had met and interviewed each of the candidates separately, and the personal interview was 35% of their overall score. The individual speeches that we just witnessed is worth 20% of the overall score tonight.
And before we move on to the next segment of our program, we would like to take a moment to recognize and meet the judges that we have on this distinguished panel. If we could have the house lights up, please.
Judge number one is Judy Hamaguchi. Ms. Hamaguchi is a Japantown-raised girl, educated through the San Francisco Unified Public School System. She attended, yes. She attended City College as a re-entry woman and continued to San Francisco State University to major in Asian American Studies and English with a focus on creative writing. She's produced and directed shows at the Asian American Theater Company and started her own grassroots production group, Asiatics Productions, which offered writers and performers an opportunity to work on their craft. For several years, she was the owner of Asobi Arts, a creative arts workshop on Post and Laguna. She's never lost her connection to Japantown. Currently, she is a board member of the San Francisco chapter of the Japanese American Citizens League and the Japantown Task Force. She considers J-Town home, a place to honor the history of all those who came before us and hopes to preserve it for generations to come. Judy Hamaguchi, would you please stand and be recognized?
That is one busy lady. Judge number two is Carla Chun Hoplett. Born in Honolulu, Hawaii, she grew up traveling the world as her father served in the U.S. Army. She pursued her Bachelor's of Business Administration at the University of Washington, Seattle, where she majored in accounting. While in Seattle, she was the 1991 Seattle Japanese Community Queen. She worked for 15 years as an accounting and finance professional for both public and private companies on the East Coast, as well as here in California. She earned her MBA at the Anderson School of Management at UCLA and currently works as a community volunteer. She resides in Hillsboro with her husband and two daughters. Please, a warm welcome for Ms. Carla Chun Hoblet. Thank you.
Judge number three is Dr. Kazuto Ishida. Dr. Ishida has had experience living in Japan, the UK, and the US, and traveling to many other places around the world. He values cross-cultural exchange and building empathy with others. As the executive director of VIA Volunteers in Asia, Dr. Ishida is dedicated to providing opportunities for people from the U.S. and Asia, including Japan, to broaden their perspectives and contribute to the society through VIA's experiential learning programs. Please give Dr. Kazuto Ishida a warm round of applause and stand.
Thank you so much. Judge number four is Yumi Alyssa Kimura. Ms. Kimura is the CEO and co-founder of LEAD, a software platform that improves company culture, employee experience, retention, and diversity through AI. Prior to LEAD, she worked as Meitu Technologies' Japan country manager and built it from scratch prior to and during their 2017 $5 billion IPO in Hong Kong. As a serial entrepreneur, she started her first business when she was 18 years old in China and graduated from one of the top private colleges, Kwansei Gakuin University in Japan. Please welcome Ms. Yumi Kimura. Thank you for being here.
Judge number five is Karen Korematsu. Ms. Korematsu is the founder and executive director of the Fred T. Korematsu Institute and the daughter of the late civil rights icon Fred Korematsu. Since her father's passing in 2005, Karen has carried on his legacy as a national public speaker, K-12 educator, and a civil rights advocate. She's received numerous awards and honors and has been interviewed on radio, podcasts, TV, and her op-eds have appeared in the New York Times and the Washington Post. Karen is honored to be a judge for the Queen program this year in tribute of her father's recent 100th birthday and the 75th anniversary of his Supreme Court case, Korematsu versus United States. We have Karen Korematsu.
And judge number six is Ms. Jane Naito. Ms. Naito is a Yonsei, or fourth generation Japanese American, and a native born San Franciscan. She teaches Sōgetsu Ikebana in the Bay Area and is a popular Ikebana demonstrator throughout California. She's exhibited at numerous Ikebana flower shows at San Francisco's DeYoung Museum and currently has an arrangement on display at the Japanese Cultural and Community Center as part of this Cherry Blossom Festival. You may view her arrangements at the Japanese Cultural Community Center tomorrow, and we would like you to please stand, Ms. Jane Naito.
And judge number seven is Erica Mariko Olson. Ms. Olson was the 2011 Nisei Week Japanese Queen. Ever a lover of games and technology, she went on to work at Riot Games and makers of League of Legends. It is now a game producer on the newly announced Stadia Games and Entertainment at Google. Let's give a warm round of applause for Erica Olson.
Thank you all, judges, for your time today. We certainly don't envy your task doing this. And for those of you who may not know, they have had a very long day, starting early with their own interviews with the candidates. So thank you so much for all of your time. A big round of applause to our distinguished judging panel.
Now we'd like to introduce our distinguished guests who are joining us in the audience this evening.
And once again, we're representing the Japanese consulate in San Francisco, Deputy Consul General, Mr. Kazuhiro Iryu. Thank you so much.
I'd like to now introduce the President of the Japanese Chamber of Commerce of Northern California, Mr. Tomomichi Saito. Accompanying Mr. Saito is Executive Director, Ms. Junko Nakagawa.
Thank you. Also joining us in the audience tonight, we'd like to recognize Japan Airlines, Mr. Taiki Ozawa, Vice President, and Japan Airlines Vice President at Regional Manager Northwestern Region. Thank you so much.
And we'd like to recognize the 52nd Annual Cherry Blossom Festival co-chairpersons, Ms. Kayomi Takeda and Mr. Greg Valoria.
And those of you might know that Kiyomi was also a member of the court, so she knows what it's like to be up here on stage. We would like to also welcome the festival's MC extraordinaire, Mr. George Yamasaki, and Miss Chinatown, San Francisco, Jessica Yen. Here in the audience, thank you so much.
Representing Miseki Jewelry and the designer of the first princess pendant, Miss Asuka Saito.
Also a designer of jewelry, she annually donates the cherry blossom pendants to the court. Ms. Kayoko Tachibana of Tachibana Designs.
We would like to introduce the court's Japanese calligraphy sensei, Ms. Kayoko Kanasawa.
And we would like to recognize with a smile, Smiley and Janet Kai of the Ukulele Source.
Please give a warm round of applause to Ms. Bernie Hui, who had created and donated the beautiful handmade kansashi to match each candidate's kimono.
And finally, please welcome representatives from a few of our festival sponsors, Kaiser Permanente, Toto, Kintetsu Travel, Union Bank, and California Bank and Trust. Will those representatives please stand and be recognized? Thank you so much. Yes, thank you for being here and joining us on this evening. All right, I think we're ready to see a little more.
Let's check it out.
Our candidates.
My creative expression for this evening is an original spoken word piece because it allows me to express myself.
My furry best friend. The day you came home was the best of them all because you also liked to play ball. You were the first one to jump, the first one to run, and the first one to come to me like the shining star. No matter the time, no matter the day, you would always jump around to play. No matter the day, I was excited to come home because you made my day, every day. You filled my heart with joy. Every time you brought a toy, you were such a good boy. No matter the day, you were always right there, on my lap, just waiting for a bath. Never thought of the day where I wouldn't be able to play with your little feisty self and not have you to myself. I'm sorry for your pain. I'm sorry for this day. I hope to see your star so that I can say hey. But I know you were happy and had a good time. Right by my side, forever and ever. Thank you for everything. I love you forever, and I will never forget you. Thank you for the memories that last for centuries. Thank you, and I love you, Cody.
Thank you.
My creative expression is singing Holy Holy Bushi. It is a song that Issei Hawaiian would sing in the fields while they were working. It was taught to me by my mother.
Traditional Japanese dance. It's a passion that was handed down to me from my mother, and I love it because it connects me to my roots. To learn from the older generation and be a role model to the younger generation.
Yeah. creative expression this evening is naginata. It is a Japanese martial art that I've been practicing since college. It has taught me what it means to be strong.
What an incredible display of different talents. This section that you just saw will be weighted for 10% of the candidate's overall score.
The judges were looking for the ability to creatively express themselves, and that's what you were seeing with them.
So a round of applause for all of them in that section. That was well done. Thank you.
So ladies and gentlemen, before we take 15 minutes for a break for intermission, we'd like to encourage you to purchase some of the raffle tickets that are available.
The tickets are $1 per ticket or $10 for 12 tickets, and all of those proceeds go to fund the court's travel expenses throughout the year as they go to Nisei Week down in Southern California, and then, of course, the Queen's trip to Japan. Part of the prizes, we can win 1-2 gift certificates for an exclusive easy-look makeup service section by the Queen Program's hair and makeup artist, Ethel Reddy.
A beautiful Ohana model SK25 soprano mahogany ukulele with bag, valued at $179, generously donated by Smiley and Janet Kai of Ukulele Source.
There's also a one-night stay at Hotel Buchanan and a C200 Toto washlet donated by Toto. So please get the, that's right, yes. Please get the raffle tickets. We will see you back here for the second part of the program in about 15 minutes. Thank you.
My favorite dessert is boba drink. Ice cream. Peachy gold ice is good. Parfait. Cheesecake. I would describe a strong woman as someone who is determined.
Decisive. Someone who knows when to speak up and when to listen.
Confident. Fighter.
My martial arts sensei.
My friends because they strive me to do better.
My brother.
My mother. She's been very inspirational to me throughout my life.
I would be able to listen to anything.
Teleportation.
Telekinesis.
Water breathing.
To fly.
All right. Welcome back to the program. We hope you had a nice break and that you're ready to see more of these wonderful candidates. This is one of my favorite parts of the program. We have the on-stage interview.
Along with the individual interviews with the judging panel, this section is the most heavily weighted segment. It's worth 35% of their overall score.
The questions that they're going to be asked are only known to me and Devin. We have been consulting backstage. And these are questions that the candidates don't know, not even the staff or the judges have been supplied with them.
The judges will score each candidate based on her ability to answer in a clear, direct, and concise manner.
So please, we'll get the lights on and welcome the candidates back to the stage.
Please have a seat. Okay, no need to be nervous. This is going to be fun. We do want to let people know, though, that we have Miki Akiyama De Jesus, who is here to give you the bell. So when she rings that bell, that means that that we'll get close to your end of time. You each have 4 minutes for this Q&A section.
So good luck, and we will start with Nami. So I know that you like making playlists for people, and you're into music. You're also into spoken words. I'm curious, how do you approach making a good playlist for somebody?
Making a good playlist for a friend or somebody, I first think of what kind of music they like. That's the first thing that I think about. And then I think about what kind of songs remind me of them and what kind of songs, in my perspective, fit their personality and their traits. And that's how I make playlists for my friends and family.
And if someone were making a playlist for you, what would be the first song?
The first song on my playlist that somebody would have made for me is Imagine by Ariana Grande. Hey.
Cool.
One thing that I'm hearing yes from some of the other people, yes. One thing I wanted to ask you about is when you're learning both Japanese and English and you're speaking them, there are certain words that you might use, women or men might use, that you might use if you're older or younger. Do you find that your personality changes when you speak in Japanese versus when you speak in English?
So my Japanese school friends and I actually have talked about this because we are all born and raised here. But we do go to the Saturday Japanese school where we speak Japanese. And we came to the conclusion that when we speak in Japanese normally, then it comes off like more polite or nicer. But being angry in a certain language, in Japanese, it's a tad more scary in Japanese to be angry.
So you get scarier when you speak in Japanese and you're angry?
I don't think I can get mad in Japanese, but other people, when I perceive them, more scary in Japanese.
You know, I feel like younger generations of Japanese Americans are trying to figure out what that means to them, how that's defined, and I wonder how you define Japanese American for yourself.
I define the identity Japanese American by an American person or American citizen whose not only racial background may be Japanese, but maybe they grew up Japanese or in the Japanese culture, and someone who embodies like Japanese culture and the heritage and the traditions built into their lives. I think that's someone and somebody who embodies a Japanese American.
And is there anyone, a Japanese person or Japanese-American person, that you would really like to meet?
A Japanese person in Japan who I would really like to meet is Naomi Watanabe, because she is such a role model for everybody in Japan and breaking the stigmatized rules of society in Japan, and being who she is for however she likes is something that I really look up to, and I would love to meet her.
You're a first generation Japanese American, and you say you've gained appreciation for your Japanese culture. In which ways have you gained appreciation for your Japanese culture?
I'm actually second generation. But over the years, as you heard in my speech, where I was embarrassed of being different and being Japanese American, differing with my friends at school, and over the years, I've come to the appreciation of the community that I belong to outside of school, whether it's Asian League basketball or Japanese Saturday Hoshuko, and this community itself is something that really helped me to become proud and be very thankful for where I come from and for my parents for allowing me to be in this type of community and be active for my community.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Our candidate number one, Navi Katie Kreisel. Next, we'll move on to Elena. You said that you like to take recipes from online and do baking. Is that correct?
Not
so much baking, just any kind of cooking?
Well, when I was in Japan after work, sometimes I'd have a little time and I would find something online, maybe a rice cooker cake recipe or something nikujaga or something like that.
So I was wondering what either the best recipe was that you've ever found or the craziest recipe that you've ever found.
I really like the rice cooker cake recipes. Like, they come in so many different varieties. There was a citrus one, oh gosh, there was a banana cake one, and I would bring those to my students at my school, and they really enjoyed them, which made me happy. I was like, I can make something. So, yeah, I would say the rice cooker cake recipes, because it just seems so odd, right? You make a cake with a rice cooker.
I didn't even know those existed. You just pour stuff in and push the button, and you come out with cake?
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay, I'm trying that. I'm gonna ask you for your recipe after.
I know you also like taking pictures, is that correct? Photographing things?
Occasionally.
What do you find yourself focusing on when you take pictures?
Well, recently I've been taking photos for my group in Japan. Every event that we have, I try to take a photo just to kind of show like the atmosphere of the event and capture like the community feeling.
One thing that I wanted to ask you about is these are, you know, for a lot of people are struggling with this current times of being very, very polarized, and people who have different ideas, different philosophies, different positions, having a difficult time kind of coming together. And I was wondering if you can share with us maybe any situation where you have found yourself face-to-face with somebody who maybe didn't have the same kind of worldview as you or outlook, and how you were able to connect or overcome that.
I think there are times when you need to reach out to a person and try to connect with them. And then I think there are times when you need to say, no, this is how I feel. This is how I strongly feel. And you can't back down from that. When I was in Japan, I worked at the table where I was the only Nikkei person. And it was all kind of a non-Japanese table of English teachers, and there were times when, maybe because I was mixed, people thought they could get away with saying certain things, and that was not okay with me. And there were times when, and this is why I made my group, it's just, there were times when I had to stand up for myself, and I had to stand up when I hear something that was just, you can't say that about Japanese people. So it's a bit different from what you asked, but I think there are times we have to just stand our ground.
Kind of following up on that question, so you did start this Japanese Americans in Japan club, and I noticed in your essay you wrote about otherness and being othered, and I wonder what are some of the experiences of people in that group being othered?
The first one that comes to mind is a very close friend of mine in Japan. He was born in Japan, but he moved to America at a young age, and he really developed an American identity. And then when he came back to Japan, he got bullied pretty mercilessly, to the point, like physical bullying. He has like a scar on his face and everything.
And he'd found his place at work, and he kind of accepted, oh, it'd be different. But through finding our group, he told me that I don't have to just carry on just feeling, oh, society isn't going to understand me. I can be with people who are of mixed cultural identity, and I can find my voice. And he said, I never would have known that I had this voice in me if I'd never found this group.
That must have been very moving. Thank you so much for sharing that story. Thank you. That was candidate number two, Elena Wilson. Thank you, Elena.
Naomi, I know you work at Takara Sake, and I want to know, what's a common misconception about sake that people come in and ask you about?
Ooh, just one?
You have many, list them off.
I really do have many, but we don't have time for that. One of the most common, I think, that people come in with is that sake is one flavor, one type. They believe that a tradition that's been developed over 2,000 years only has one flavor profile. And I very happily and graciously disabuse them of that.
in the talent section, you were showing the Nihon Buyo. And I was wondering, as somebody who is kind of 4.5 generation, what was it about that particular art form that drew you in and that made you want to learn that?
My mother has been dancing buyo since she was 8 years old. As a half Japanese American, my mom used buyo as a way to connect with her culture and her roots. And I grew up seeing this beautiful expression of self-identity, and I fell in love with it, but I never thought that it was something that I could achieve personally. In middle school, I started dancing minyo with my mother and my older sister, and minyo was wonderful and lots of fun. But in university, I had the opportunity to start studying buyo with my mom, and it was incredible. So I think my mom's passion for the art form really spurred and fueled my own.
As I mentioned earlier, younger generations sometimes have a hard time connecting with their heritage. I know this is something that you want to do. Why is this important to you?
Because when we don't feel connected to our heritage, when we don't feel like we have a community that we can belong to, or that we have an identity that we can believe in, it's so easy to feel lost and isolated and alone. And I have known so many young Japanese Americans, myself included, who struggle with not understanding their place in the world. And I think that finding identity and finding culture and finding community is one of the most important things that anybody can do, no matter what that identity is.
And when you're talking about community, I mean, here in San Francisco, we're very fortunate to have one of the few remaining Japan towns, Nihonmachi. So looking at this community as a place, if you were to become queen, what kinds of things do you think might be effective to bring in Shin Issei, people who don't have any Japanese heritage, or young Japanese Americans who might be 4.5 or Gosei or Rosei? What are your thoughts on that?
I think each of the examples that you brought up just now has its own necessary path. When interacting with Issei and Nisei, Shin Issei, Shin Nisei, you want to approach them in a different way than you would approach a Yonsei who's maybe struggling to find their cultural identity. When you're talking to Shin Issei and Shin Nisei, you want to show them that they're accepted, that they have community, even though their identity, what they believe of themselves, is possibly different. They don't see themselves always as Japanese American, but rather Japanese. And I think opening up the community to them and allowing them to understand that, yes, I am Japanese American, would be the first step. For younger students, I think you need to learn to connect with them more. Like I was saying, the narratives of the Issei and Nisei pioneers are incredible and they're inspiring, but there are a lot of youth who don't resonate with that. So how can we bring a modern view to the youth?
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Candidate number two.
Stephanie, you are a clinical laboratory scientist. What's your favorite thing about being a clinical laboratory scientist?
My favorite part about being a clinical laboratory scientist is I get to contribute to something that's so much bigger than myself. I get to touch almost every patient, whereas a nurse can only focus on maybe one or two patients a day. I get all the samples from multiple campuses that UCSF has, Mission Bay, Parnassus, Mount Zion, and I think that's such a wonderful thing that what I can contribute touches so many people.
There's been a lot of discussion about women in STEM and, you know, science, technology, engineering, math careers, and I wanted to ask you about your own path to this career and what you think could be done to bring more young girls and more women into these kinds of fields.
I believe that we should promote more programs to outreach to maybe individuals that wouldn't necessarily highlight the science or the mathematics in the schools. I worked for 2 years at this program called Cura, where they focused on low-performing students in high-risk areas in San Francisco. And what I found was a lot of these individuals, they come from a very difficult, very troubled past and don't have access to such information. And through this program, I was able to really focus on these students, really help them in their schooling and make them think about a potential future that they wouldn't have otherwise thought about.
So I also know that you would like to help others find their voice through inspiration and dance. And I think the word voice is very powerful, but I want to know what does voice and finding your voice mean to you?
I think your voice is taking something that means so much to you and sharing it with the people you care about, people that you want to listen. And by me performing for 18 years, I am a role model to the younger generation, young dancers that are here tonight, actually. And they're in the back. I love them very much. And I hope that they will continue, even when they go away for college, that they will come back and remember the Japanese community and continue to give back.
30 states by the time you're 30. What is at the top of your list and why?
My current next project is to go to Colorado. I really want to go to Mount Zion. Or not to Mount Zion. I really want to go to Zion National Park. I'm sorry. I'm UCSF. Yeah, I went hiking a lot as a child. My father took us to many places. I climbed Half Dome when I was 10 years old. Probably not the safest parental decision, but I never forget it. The views are amazing, and yeah, that's my next project.
Awesome, thank you.
Thank you very much. Can't wait to report that. You said that you liked singing, and I'm wondering when you go and sing, or if you sing at karaoke or karaoke, when some people say, what's your favorite song?
For the first time in forever. It's a song from Frozen. I know that most people, when they think of Frozen, it's the other song. I'm not going to name it. But for me, it's For the First Time in Forever. I absolutely love that song. I think I love how vibrant it is, how absolutely full of energy it is as well. So definitely that song.
You shared with us your a little bit of your Naginata skills.
Yes.
What is your favorite part? I mean, I feel like there's so many there's so much that goes into it, just mentally and physically. But I wondered, like, what got you into it and why? What is your favorite part of Naginata?
Originally, I loved Naginata because of its choreographed movements. That's something that I didn't show tonight. It's called Engi or Kata. I think maybe some people who know other martial arts might know it, but as Kata. And I loved that in the very beginning, but when I moved to the Northern California Naginata Federation back from college in Toronto, my sensei said, all right, gear up, you're gonna put on bogu, which is armor. And it was something that I was, oh my God, I was like, oh my God, I can't do that. But I did it, and it was a moment that I realized that so many of the things that I thought I couldn't do, so many things that I thought, it's not me. You just need somebody else to believe in you and to push you further. I think that's something that I've learned in martial arts in general, and I hope that all of you who have experienced something similar may hopefully resonate with that. It's that sort of feeling where you feel like you can't do something, but then somebody tells you, no, you can do it, and you are astounded by what you can do.
And you mentioned going to school, going to college in Canada.
Yes.
I was wondering, what was your biggest challenge that you found kind of moving into Toronto, and biggest challenge or the biggest difficulty?
The biggest difficulty definitely wasn't the language, because thankfully it was all English. Most people ask me, did you have to speak French? But actually Toronto is mainly English. It probably was finding a community there. I went to Toronto and I didn't have anybody that I knew over there. And I decided that I need to put myself out there, try new things, try to find a new community. And actually that's where I found Naginata. And it helped me so much with building a sort of friendship and identity as well. It was a big formative year for me, so definitely.
So you say you love bringing people together to work towards a common goal.
Yes.
And in a world right now that seems very polarizing, have you ever had to bring together people on opposing sides? And what was your approach to having to work with people who might have different viewpoints?
During college, I was the president of my Naginata club, but also I taught as well, which meant that I had to build the curriculum. And some of the board members, we had a 12-person board member, they didn't always agree with the way that I was going to build my curriculum. And what I found that was really important was to listen to what other people have to say, even though it might be hard, because it's not always easy to listen to opposition voice. And sometimes you feel personally attacked, but you have to realize that everybody has their own opinions and to respect that. But at the same time, something that I learned that was even more important was to believe in myself. So when I thought that this is the path, I needed to put myself there and just tell them, this is how we're gonna go, please believe in me.
Thank you.
Thank you.
A hand for Yuki, and actually a hand for
all of the candidates. Yeah. Well done. I know that isn't the easiest thing to get questions that you're not prepared for. Thank you all, appreciate it. Well, we hope that gave you a little bit of insight, hopefully the judges too, into some of the candidates with a more spontaneous kind of having to respond on their feet.
Yeah, it's fun for us.
It was fun for us too, yeah. We would now like to invite to the podium someone that many of you know dearly, the Queen Program Chairperson Emeritus, Mr. Ben Nakajo.
Blossom, welcome to you all. I've been assigned the most important responsibility My duty is to convey to you the corporate sponsors, candidate sponsors, and Queen program supporters our deepest, most sincere, heartfelt community gratitude to recognize you for your immensely important contributions to our Cherry Blossom Queen program and to our Sakura Festival. Why do we need your support? And why do we need to express our deepest gratitude? As times change quickly, decade to decade, 1900, 2000, 2019, changes from generation to generation, Nisei, Sansei, Yonsei, Gosei. We sometimes wonder in this quickness where we are going and what is the future of the community, the Japanese American community. Where, why did we come from? Where are we going? What will we leave when the time passes? We, festival, community, stand united to maintain, to preserve, and to sustain this traditional and cultural experience of Japanese Americanism through the media of this festival. This Cherry Blossom Festival, this Sakura Matsuri, is to honor our ancestors, to perpetuate ourselves, and to learn and to leave a legacy for the generations to come. You, our corporate, candidate, and program sponsors, are critical in this experience, for without you, this entire festival, this entire Queen program, and all its meaning would not take place. Due to your generosity, we are able to continue on, and we spend every effort of that generosity to benefit this experience. To extend my thoughts and appreciation further, this thankful feeling must be included and extended to this Queen Program Committee. As a program torch has been passed to new leadership, they are committed, dedicated, and devoted. Amazing energy to continue this important program. Queen Program Committee, I love you. 2018 Northern California Festival Court. We salute your many, many efforts this past year representing this community in various aspects. Well done. Yoku yatta. I charge you not to forget this past year. Forget not the individual reasons why you came to us, to this program, to find your beginnings, to search for your community, to find your place as Japanese American women. And you must further carry on these experiences and these lessons learned these past many months to apply to your future years, to share with your peers and the generations to follow. These invaluable experiences were afforded to you by the generous community spirit and support of the corporate candidate sponsors and program supporters that I am recognizing now. So honorable corporate candidate sponsors and supporters of this Cherry Blossom Festival Queen Program Committee, we express from the deepest part of our community heart, our kokoro, appreciation for your contributions to this Japanese American continuing story. May you always enjoy corporate prosperity, success, health, and happiness. May the returns from your generous support and your giving be increased 10,000-fold back to you. Jana Katsuyama, Devin Katayama, our respect and our affection. Thank you. Arigatou gozaimasu. Arigatou gozaimashita. Kokoro kara kansha itashimasu.
Thank you so much, Devin.
So we are nearing the selection of our 2019 Northern California Cherry Blossom Queen and Court. And at this time, we'd like to take a moment to briefly share the 2018 Court's journey.
Sakurai, Princess Rachel Mika Kawawaki, and Princess Lauren Kiva Matsuno. Ladies, thank you so much for your service and representing us this past year.
Good evening, ladies. ladies and gentlemen, my name is Nikki Tachiki, and I'm honored to be the 2018 Northern California Cherry Blossom Festival Queen. This year has been an incredible experience for me, Maya, Emery, Rachel, and Lauren. We traveled throughout the Bay Area and volunteered with Japanese and Japanese American organizations and community members. We developed our leadership and interpersonal skills, and we learned more about ourselves and about our Japanese American culture. We would like to thank our sponsors, the Nihonmachi Street Fair, the Japanese Chamber of Commerce of Northern California, Takarasake USA Incorporated, Benihana, and the Nikkei Lions Club of San Francisco for making this opportunity possible for us. Thank you to this community and to our local organizations who welcomed us with open arms and taught us, through example, the importance of giving back and caring for others. Thank you to our family and friends for supporting us throughout this year. We couldn't have done it without you. Traveling to Los Angeles and Hawaii to meet the women on our sister city courts were two of the highlights of our year. We would like to thank our sister city courts and hospitality committees of Nisei Week and Hawaii Cherry Blossom Festival. And I would like to thank the Fujiyasu Kimono Company for their hospitality during my visit to Japan and for continuing to support the Queen program. Thank you to the Northern California Cherry Blossom Festival Committee and co-chairs, Kiyomi Takeda and Greg Villaria, and a huge thank you to the Queen Program Committee, Ben Nakajo, Mickey Novitsky, Yuko Walton, Lauren Suguru, and the rest of the committee. You invested so much to develop us as young women and leaders of this community, and we each hold our experiences in this program so close to our hearts. Lastly, I would like to thank the ladies standing next to me. Lauren continued to put her heart into this program as she juggled medical school. Lauren, you always keep a positive attitude, and you always reminded us to smile when we were surrounded by cameras at events. You are so sweet, intelligent, and hardworking, and we are so proud of you. Rachel and her mom fulfilled the most important role. You kept our bellies full, and you carried snacks with you everywhere we went. It's hard to remember you're the baby of the group because you kept us so grounded throughout this year. You and Emery were the backbone of our court, the constant and reliable presence through all the changes we went through. Emery should be every woman's inner voice. She's hardworking, driven, business-minded, and also creative, artistic, and generous. There's nothing she cannot accomplish when she puts her mind to it. Maya, you put your heart and soul into this program, into this community, and to us. Early in our year, you taught us to learn to rely on one another, and as a result, we continue to grow so close throughout this year. I cannot imagine going through this experience with anyone else, and you made this experience truly memorable for me. On behalf of the 2018 court, we wish the 2019 candidates a year of amazing experiences and hope that they share the love and support for each other that we experienced this year. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ladies. And really, people here in the community, you know they are hardworking. The Queen Program Night is just the beginning. They have been at all of the events, selling raffle tickets, smiling, representing this community so well. Well done, ladies, well done. お疲れ様でした. We would like them to remain, all of you to remain on stage, because now is the time to announce the 2018 Tomodachi Award recipient.
So earlier today, each of the outgoing court members had individually chosen one of their fellow court members on a secret ballot that exemplified the feeling of friendship and congeniality throughout the duration of their entire year. The ballots were collected and tabulated by our auditors this evening.
And we will be getting that envelope. The court member will be honored with the Tomodachi Award, Tomodachi meaning friend. Their selflessness, honesty, and hard work as a team player throughout the year is what this award represents. It is annually donated by the 1992 Miss Tomodachi, Miss Hamada Wong, and we thank Miss Wong for her support. We would also like to ask if we could have the envelope, please.
It's on its way out.
They are still tabulating.
I just heard a, hold on, we're getting it? Yes.
Sure. And one of the things that I think, if you could please raise your hand, the member of the court who put together that wonderful video, I understand. Thank you so much. A big round of applause to her. That is something which I think every year is always a highlight, because oftentimes we don't get to see, we see them here in the community, but also they are traveling to Hawaii and they are traveling to Southern California. So it is a wonderful thing to be able to see pictures of their trips there, to be able to see how they have represented us. And also the fun part of, we talk about the mentorship and we talk about the leadership here. Well, that is also going on both in LA and in Hawaii.
Yeah, I mean, you can see it in the pictures that you just saw up there. The one word I've been hearing over and over tonight is this word community. And that's something that I think a lot of us here really value, and you can see it. And I just really appreciate that from somebody who's first time here hosting and emceeing this event and being here. So thank you so much. And we have the envelope now.
And we have the envelope. So I will let you do the honors of reading it off.
All right.
Again, the Tomodachi Award for the 2018 court.
Maya Jessica Hernandez. Congratulations, Maya.
Congratulations, Maya. The 2018 court, Miss Tomodachi. She had to wait a long time to hear that. And Maya is being presented with a Hakata Ningyo by the 2017 Princess and Tomodachi Award recipient Telly Owe. Thank you for the court, to the court, for this tremendous year. Please, a big round of applause to the 2018 court and the Miss Tomodachi winner, Maya Hernandez. Thank you so much, ladies, for all of your contributions this past year. Okay, as they exit the stage, I think we are now ready for the raffle drawing.
Raffle prize drawing. Before the announcements, the next announcements, we're gonna find out who the raffle prize winners are. So Nikki, if you please remain on the stage and hang out for a sec.
And I think we are going to be bringing in the numbers. If you have your tickets, if you could please get them out. And as we call the number, we have ushers who are here in the hall, and they will be going to, if you hear your ticket read, please raise your hand and one of the ushers will come and find you and verify the ticket. So if we could have the house lights are up.
So yeah, the winner is gonna be given their prizes at the end of the show at the raffle table located at the back of the floor level of this theater, theater number one. So please look for Nina Myers to receive your prize.
And the first raffle prize that we will be drawing for is the first of two exclusive makeup service session gift certificates worth $75 that was donated kindly by Ethel Reddy of E The Look, the official makeup artist and hairstylist for the Queen program. So Nikki, as your final duty here in the end of the court service, please draw the number. And that ticket number is 835-312. 835-312. If that's your number, please raise your hand and we will come and find you. This is again for a makeup session with Ethel, with Ethel Reddy. Yes, we have a winner!
Take a bow.
Excellent. 835-312.
All right.
There we go.
The second raffle prize is the second $75 gift session exclusive makeup service donated by Ethel Reddy of E The Look. And the winning number is 835-201. 835-201. $75 gift certificate. Exclusive makeup.
He's leaning forward to see if he got the second one as well.
835-201. Looking for 835-201. All right, we got a hand
Ben!
Over here. All right. Winner over here, if you can check the ticket. Yes, you may.
Okay, and the next prize. We have an overnight stay at the Hotel Buchanan, donated by Emily Glick, the general manager of the Hotel Buchanan. And the winner? The winning ticket number is 835-603. 835. Oh!
Oh yeah,
that hand shot up. 835-603 for the overnight stay at the Hotel Buchanan.
Cool.
Thumbs up.
Next prize I'm really excited about. We will announce the winner of the beautiful Ohana Model SK25 Soprano Mahogany Ukulele with Gig Bag. Valued over $179. This ukulele, as well as the ones given to the 2019 Corps members, are generously donated by Smiley and Janet Kai of Ukulele Source in San Jose. Okay. And that winning number is 835-380. 835-380. All right,
oh,
here we go.
Oh my God.
Right here in front. 835-380. 835-380. Good. All right. Last but not least is the C200 Toto Washlet, donated by our festival sponsor, Toto. And that winning number is...
These are really fancy.
836-290.
836-290.
Oh, I hear
we have
that.
It,
yeah.
There you go. 836-290. But if it wasn't you, I hear they have a booth in the Cherry Blossom Festival, so you can go and get your own Toto Washlet too.
Congratulations, and again, please pick up your award at the end of the show at the exit door of this theater, number one, orchestra level from Nina Myers.
And thank you again to Nikki and to Jackie for your help with that. Thank you so much. And now, we would like to invite the 2019 President of the Japanese Chamber of Commerce of Northern California, Mr. Tomomichi Saito, to join us on stage, along with our festival co-chairpersons, Ms. Kiyomi Takeda, and her co-chair, Mr. Greg Zeloria. Thank you all for joining us tonight. Please come on stage.
The Japanese Chamber of Commerce is a continuous supporter of the festival, as you know, and has made many generous donations to allow the continuation of the festivities. Their financial support enables us to share our culture, our community, and to celebrate here in San Francisco and in Northern California.
My name is Omo Haito, from Japanese Chamber of Commerce of Northern California, JCCN. I'm very proud and honored to stand here. And JCCNC, as you know, has a long history to support and donate this event as well as Queen program. And I would like to request all the new Queen and Princess to spread and Japanese and U.S. cultures and history of Sakura Matsuri so that the next generation or children or grandchildren can understand and repeat the Japanese history. So I'm trying to or support and donation. So, on behalf of JCCNC, I would present and support donation for the amount of $4,550. for this evening. Thank you.
Thank you so much. We so appreciate the sponsorship and the generous donation by the Chamber of Commerce. As you saw by the court's video, as well as the camaraderie of our outgoing court that was displayed on stage, the court goes through quite a bit during the year, but it is also clear that it is there has been a lot of work that has been put in by each of these candidates leading up to this moment. The rehearsals, the practices with the dancing, the thought that goes into what they're saying when they're giving their personal speeches. So we'd like to now take a look.
Take a brief moment to look at the 2019 candidates' journey.
Out in the world, I'll sing a song. It's a better place since you came along. Since you came along, your touch is sunlight through the trees. Your kisses are the ocean breeze. Everything's alright when you're with me.
choreographed by program director Nikki Katsuyama-Novitsky, and the music Arliss Symphony, Remo and Zovino is a soundtrack for the movie Van Gogh of Wheat Field and Clouded Skies.
Let's give another big final round of applause to the 52nd Annual Northern California Festival Sharing Philosophy. As we're about to reveal the results of this evening, it's our pleasure to mention and thank the auditors who've been calculating the candidate scores tonight.
They are Han Bei, CPA of Ernst & Young, Auditor Lynn Higa, Vice President, retired of Union Bank, and Auditor Douglas Nakatani, Assistant Vice President, retired from Bank of the West.
We truly appreciate all you've done tonight and the work that you've done. So big round of applause. Thank you so much.
And as we are waiting for those envelopes, it is time to find out who will be chosen as the title holders for our 52nd annual Northern California Cherry Blossom Festival. These five young women, all of you worked so hard, and I hope that you all feel very proud of what you've accomplished just leading up to your being here on stage.
In the event that the Queen is unable to fulfill her duties, the first princess will assume the role as the Northern California Cherry Blossom representative.
Ladies, thank you for all of your devotion and hard work leading up to this moment. I hope you all feel very proud. Can we give them a big round of applause? Job well done. Now we have the envelope that I can't seem to open.
Give it a good tear.
All right. The 2019 Northern California Cherry Blossom First Princess is Naomi Leilani Furukawa. Congratulations.
Naomi is being crowned by 2018 First Princess Maya Hernandez and sashayed by 2018 Princess Rachel Mika Kawawaki.
And her tiara is donated by the 1999 First Princess Ms. Amy Tsujishi and Mr. Kerry Honda. The First Princess sash is donated by 2014 First Princess and Tomodachi Award recipient, Ms. Allison K. Pola Nishiyama.
Since 1999, a very special gift is given to the First Princess, generously donated by Mr. Masaharu Nagasuga of Miseki Jewelry.
And being awarded the first-year princess gets a Japanese Akoya pearl with colorstone necklace made of amethyst, citrine, topaz, garnet, kyanite, and peridot. In the middle, there is a freshwater pearl sitting on a flower made of Swarovski crystals.
And here to present the necklace made for the first princess is the designer of this beautiful work of art, Ms. Asuka Saito.
And thanks so much to Ms. Saito. And Naomi is also going to be awarded the Northern California Cherry Blossom Festival First Princess Award, being presented by the Festival General Co-Chair, Mr. Greg Villoria. Thank you so much, Greg. A big round of applause. Our first princess for the 2019 court.
And now the moment we've all been waiting for, the 52nd annual Northern California Cherry Blossom Festival Queen is Yuki Nishimura. Congratulations, Yuki.
Congratulations. Yuki is receiving her crown by the 2018 Queen Nicole May Tachiki. She's being sashed by the 2018 Princess Emery Sakurai.
The Queen's tiara is donated by 1992 Queen Gail Udeno Tanaka and her husband Dean Tanaka. The sash is donated by 2013 Queen Kelly Yuka Wolf.
And we also have Mr. Ben Nakajol coming with the Queen's bouquet. And on behalf of the Fujiyasu Kimono Company, that beautiful history that you saw presented by former Queen Jacqueline Chu. This is part of the long tradition of the Cherry Blossom Queen program. The kimono is being presented by the 2012 and 2013 Queen and Program co-chairs. We have Ms. Kelly Yuko Walton, who's here representing with the beautiful Fujiyasu kimono.
It also includes a matching obi, zori, and all other essential accessories used to wear this beautiful kimono.
So you will be seeing her throughout the Cherry Blossom Festival wearing this.
And as Northern California Cherry Blossom Festival Queen, Yuki will be going on a goodwill tour of Japan. She's receiving two tickets on Japan Airlines presented by Mr. Taiki Ozawa, Vice President and Regional Manager of the Northwestern Region.
And there, as part of the goodwill tour, Yuki will be able to go and visit Japan, be the ambassador for Northern California, representing our community here. Thank you so much to Japan Airlines. The Queen will also be receiving a Northern California Cherry Blossom Queen Award from the festival's co-chairperson, Clarima Award recipient, 2010 court member, Ms. Kiyomi Takeda. And the princesses are receiving tiaras donated by members of the 2014 court. Ali Mieko Dameshigi, Kristen Matsumoto, Allison Nishiyama, Saya Sakurai, Kyle Tana, and the princess sashes donated by the 1996 princess Sarina Hasegawa Fat, presented by the 2018 princesses Rachel Kawawaki, Lauren Matsuno, and Emily Sakurai. Thank you so much. These are our court members who are going to be representing us throughout next weekend's festival tomorrow, as well as the grand parade on Sunday.
The Queen is also receiving an Ohana model CK20 concert mahogany ukulele with a gig bag. This package includes the 6-time Grammy winner Daniel Ho's instructional DVD, a chord chart, tuner, and a Cynthia Lynn autographed CD called Ukulele Days. Rieko Inaba of North American Trading Company has generously donated beautiful cherry blossom designed tea sets for the princesses of the court.
And thank you so much for those donations. The Sakura pendant, which has become a symbol of each court's association to this Queen program and this Cherry Blossom Festival, is once again being generously donated by Kayoko Tachibana of Kayoko Designs.
Representing the Cherry Blossom alumni, 1997 Queen Cindy Sakai Kim and 2011 Princess Lauren Sachi Kawawaki. Presenting the CBA's donation of gift boxes to the court containing gift cards, beauty supplies, and various items donated by members of the CBA.
And thank you so much to that CBA, the Cherry Blossom alumni, made up of former members of previous courts. The Queen Program Committee has also gifted the court matching happy coats with the festival's logo, which they will be able to wear at various events. They don't go to all of the events in evening gowns, so I can tell you that for sure. Ben Kyoto has also donated a beautiful Kate Spade purse to all of the members to carry on their journey throughout the year.
The Nichibei Foundation has generously donated a one-year subscription of the Nichibei Weekly to the court. It's an invaluable resource of community news that can be utilized throughout the year.
And the beautiful kanzashi of the court worn in the first half of the program was donated by Ms. Bernie Hui, Ms. Hiroko Sato, and her mother, Ms. Yoko Sato. The lovely floral bouquets, corsage, and boutonnieres were designed by Ms. Naomi Katsuyama Wan, and the candidate sponsor lays were created by Ms. Pat Fong Da Silva. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2019 Cherry Blossom Queen and Court. Congratulations, ladies. Thank you so much. And we are going to ask for people to remain in house just briefly for a photo shoot with the Queen. So get your cameras ready. Joining us, please, very quickly, the Deputy Consul Kazuhiro Iru, Tomomichi Saito, Bruce Iwafuchi, Mark Potter, Richard Ju, Koji Ito, Taiki Ozawa, Kiyomi Takeda, Mr. Greg Viloria, Mr. Tom Hoshiyama, Greg Yamasaki, George Yamasaki, Asuka Saito, Gail Tanaka, Cindy Sakai, the 2018 court, Ms. Asaki Osato, Ms. Yuko Walden, and Ben Nakajol.
And please line up stage left where you see Miki Katsuyama Novitsky at the end of the program.
And to everyone, on behalf of the 2019 Northern California Cherry Queen Program and the Cherry Blossom Festival, we'd like to thank all of the sponsors and all of you for coming, supporting the people on stage, and supporting this program. To the candidates, well done.
This is such a cool way to start the 52nd annual Northern California Cherry Blossom Festival. So thank you, everybody, for coming out, and thank you for showing your support for these young, wonderful young ladies and candidates.
Yes, thank you so much. It's been so much fun. I'm so glad you were able to
amazing.
Join this.
I love it.
And we appreciate your coming this year. Hope to see you throughout the festival and also next year. Have a wonderful evening. Thank you so much for joining us.